That's right. It's about to go down.
That's so good.
Oh, bro, don't do this to me.
Again. Oh, shit. The people have requested. The people have inquired. The people have asked. Oof, they have asked. And most importantly, the people have begged. You, Fabrizio, what's up, buddy? How's that Lover album reaction coming along? You, working on the Lover album review. When are we getting it? Settle down, everyone. Settle down. Reaction to Lover is coming very soon, best believe. I was on the clock. Time is up, and we are here. Today is the day. The Lover reaction is coming. What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new, welcome aboard. My name is Fabrizio Salerno. I'll give you a quick MO. A little over a week ago, I reacted to Taylor Swift's 1989 for the first time ever. So it was definitely an eye-opener for me. I was definitely anxious and eager, and I was anticipating what type of sound she was going to bring on that project. Because it was critically acclaimed via Spotify as one of the best albums of the 2010s. Apparently, I was under a rock for the 2010s. Me being a Kanye West fan, Kanye has delivered timeless albums of old. Of new, we have a little shaky relationship, I'm not gonna lie. But Kanye of old, from Life of Pablo backwards, classics. Album behind me, College Dropout, arguably the greatest debut album. Follows that, Late Registration, classic. Follows that with Graduation, one of my favorite Kanye West albums, incredible. 808s and Heartbreaks, stellar. My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy is arguably the best album that came out in 2010, if I'm being completely honest. In 2010, that is probably the best album that has ever touched anyone's ears. The way that it was flowed, sequenced, lyrics, production, you name it, Kanye was in his bag, and you gotta give him the credit for that for sure. Now, with that being said, taking anything away from Kanye, that's where the fandom sticks out to me. Strictly the music. All the media, outside stuff, what he says, that's just the artist being the artist. Just let him do him. That's just Ye being Ye at the end of the day, really. But that's where the fandom, that's where the line draws. So strictly music, outside stuff, obviously formulating my opinions on certain things, but I never was out on social media campaigning in support of him and stuff like that. That's not my MO, that's not my personality. I'm not about that. It's all strictly for the music. And it's like that with a lot of artists too. All strictly for the music. Even playing field. Now, 1989 was stellar. A lot of people, based on the fandom, based on the references, they're like, yo, you gotta listen to Reputation. Stellar album. It was so good to the point that people, when they wanted me to react to the tour, I had to take a little more time with that album so I could know some lyrics. So if I'm going to a concert, essentially, whether it is watching it, I'm not just gonna sit there and bob my head, judge the way she's dancing, judging her outfits and stuff like that. No, I want to be able to feel what the fans are feeling. I got in my bag and I memorized enough lyrics to the point where I was able to vibe. And clearly the reaction is there. Everyone enjoyed my vibing, so I definitely appreciate that. Now, coming off the heels of Reputation, they said Lover is the album to look at. And I got a few requests to do Lover or Red. Only reason why I'm doing Lover is A, it continues the storyline from what I'm told, and B, found out that this Sunday she's releasing her first live show, performance, whatever you may call it, from this release of this album, Lover. So it's only right I listen to the actual album before watching the concert and giving my review and take on it, before even watching the Miss Americana doc, just to even, I'm all about aesthetics, just to make it flow. So with that being said, Lover, I gotta see what Taylor's gonna bring onto Lover. The first track is titled, I Forgot You Existed. Ooh, I like this beat. It's nice and bubbly. And I couldn't get away from you. In my feelings more than Drake, so yeah, you're me. In my feelings more than Drake. Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Come on now. You know, that reference is clear. That reference is clear. In my feelings more than Drake. Shout out to Drake, man. One of my favorite artists for sure. And it was so nice. It isn't love, it isn't hate, it's just indifference. Yo, what? Oh man, Taylor is coming different with this album. You could tell that it's obviously it's more upbeat. It comes off the dark cloud, that storm with the media and everything that she went through with Reputation. Now it's as if that cloud has been lifted. I'm liking it. I'm really enjoying the first track. And I would have stuck around for you. Okay. Would have fought the whole town, so yeah. Then one magical night.
I forgot that you existed.
It's fire. What? The beat switches is crazy because I like how she's still sticking to that element that I loved on her previous project, especially Reputation. I'll have the beat, it'll just flatten out, just stop, and then Taylor will just get back into the bag.
Nice. I like this. Hate is just indifference.
Yo, Taylor.
Clear message taught me some hard lessons.
Okay.
It's all just a blur.
Ooh, I forgot that you Man, I love the Taylor. You can tell she's 100% more confident on this record because she's like, she's just out here. Like, she's doing her thing. Just because I forgot you existed doesn't mean, you know, we didn't see eye to eye. I'm just, like she said, the storm was gone. Here we are.
I thought you would kill me, but it didn't.
She's so happy.
I did. It isn't hate. It's just indifference.
This flow is so fire.
It's just indifference. So, yeah.
Oh, yeah, indeed. Listen, you could tell right now, this obviously is a whole different vibe. It has a whole different intro to what I was used to based on, you know, Welcome to New York, Ready for It, and Now I Forgot that You Existed. This right here, this is Taylor coming out to her fans, coming out to everyone, letting them know I'm out here living my best life. Yeah, I mean, that's how I'm seeing it at least. You know, it's just her and her lover Joe, and it's her coming out of that storm of the whole Reputation era, all the darkness and everything. We're starting it off with that poppy feel. The beat, honestly, it reminds me of that DJ Khaled song with Justin Bieber, Quavo, and Chance the Rapper, No Brainer. He's seen guy in the club, baby, it's a no-brainer. It's got that same element. It's an upbeat song. I rock with it. I like the intro. We're going to move on to the next track here. The next one is titled Cruel Summer. Wait. Bieber. My castle crumbled overnight. I brought a knife to a gunfight. Is that the same beat? Is that the same beat, just like a continuation? If that is, I gotta, this song is already.
I'm always waiting for you to be waiting below. Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes, and it's blue.
Okay.
Shape of your body is blue.
All right.
It's cruel summer.
Holy shit, I just had this thought. Holy shit. I don't think she's done with the Kanye shots. I really don't think. She's titling the song Cruel Summer. Kanye West and his the whole label Good Music have a whole collection album project titled Cruel Summer. It's not to the hardcore Reputation where it's a nice uppercut to knockout punch like that combo, but it's a solid, you know, jab that is like, ah, like you know what it is though. Heard that right? We got another headlights reference. Alrighty. This is like the fourth one I've heard. From what I'm getting the vibe so far, Cruel Summer, essentially, it's her and her lover Joe, right? I'm just saying, it's clear as day. It's about Joe. But what I'm seeing, at least with her lover Joe, there it's a cruel summer because the storm is over. So now she's reflecting with Joe because first track, I Forgot that You Existed. Now they're together. Now they're together, and now that she's reflecting on the cruel summer that she had. Is that a reference to Delicate? Is that a reference to Delicate? Please let me know down below if it is, because this point I'm about to make will be completely pointless if that's not it. She said she cried home from the bar. Delicate starts off bar on the east side where you at. And then she enters that vulnerable state where she's like, you know, is it cool that I said all that? Is it too soon to do this here? Because I know that it's delicate. Apparently it was too delicate because she was crying on the way home from the bar. What? If that's the case, let me know down below, because that valid point would have been pointless. But let me know, please. Okay. All right. Giving off that Avril Lavigne type of vibe, you know? That's how I'm getting it, at least. I'm rocking with it. I'm rocking with this track. Way she concluded that song where she's just literally screaming her impassioned love. You gotta acknowledge it. You gotta take it. You gotta take it for what it is. You gotta take it. Obviously, it's a totally different vibe. But if you care about the artist, you definitely want to hear what they're emphasizing in their lyrics. And right now, Cruel Summer, I like that a lot. I will definitely enjoy that track. We're going to move on to the next one, track number 3 on this album. This one is titled Lover. Oh, it's the title of the album. Duh.
You can leave the Christmas lights up till January.
As you should. Keep them up.
Our place, we made the rules.
Oh.
Have I known you 20 seconds or 20 years?
Okay, Taylor, so now they moved into a nice home together. You could tell. They're comfy. She's like, have I known you for 20 seconds or 20 years? It feels like an eternity because this love is eternal. This love that we have, this bond is eternal. And we're just so comfy together. We could keep the Christmas lights up until January. I know people that are too cozy. They could keep those Christmas lights up until the next Christmas. They just keep it up all year. They just let those lights rock. I'm like, bro, just take them down. But you could keep them up as you please. It's not my home. This house is not a home without these two. And that's clearly what Taylor is emphasizing. This house is not a home without you. So together, we're making this home. Aw, man. This song is definitely, it's going to touch right here.
Yeah, fine.
Okay. One more time, please.
Lover.
Ooh, like that a lot. The, it's just little, I don't know, for me, every time I listen to any song and I hear little nuances like that, it just literally flips the switch and it turns the whole track together. That was clean. Stops, and then you get into Lover, as she said it like that. This is a soulful track. This is the type of song that potentially you could slow dance to at a wedding. That's how I'm seeing it.
We could let our friends crash in the living room.
Okay.
Our place, we made the call.
Ooh.
I've loved you 3 summers now, honey, but I want them all.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand? The force of a man to be mine.
Ooh, okay. I like this. If this, it's because on New Year's Day, she found the one, obviously, on New Year's Day. She wanted to clean up bottles on New Year's Day. Turns out the little exchanging of cleaning up those bottles turned into something bigger. They moved into a home together. They celebrating with friends. The friends could potentially stay. It's our house, our rules, essentially, our shots, as she said. We call the shots, man. This is just, it's giving me chills. This is a whole different space that she's in, because on 1989, different vibe. She talked about darling, how she's the nightmare dressed like the daydream. Now all that stuff is out the window. This is like you're my lover, as she said. This is something else. There's no other words. I'm literally at awe, man. This her headspace right now, it makes me actually proud of her. Of everything of the songs I've listened to, what she overcame, this is just like go Taylor, like, you know what I'm saying? This is something else. Those drums are just kicking in.
Lover.
Oh, that was fire. Okay. That track right there, there's no words to even describe it. It's just a great feeling, and just listening to it. Especially a lot of Taylor fans, you guys could definitely fill me in and let me know if you have the same feeling. But just me, because all the albums are so fresh in my mind, right? So hearing what she did, what she went through in 1989, hearing the dark, edgy Taylor coming out and embracing all the mean hatred, everything that was up against her, how she overcame those odds and talked her shit. Now we're getting into here. Hearing Lover, there's nothing you could do. The words honestly can't even be fathomed and put into sentences to explain Lover. You literally just, you put a smile on my face. That's how I'm seeing it. This song puts a smile on my face because it lets me know that the artist, that their headspace, it's in the right place. She literally made all the right moves in all the right places, and she's embracing what's going on. We're gonna get into the next track here. The next track is titled The Man. That's interesting. I do have my good share of WWE. Becky Lynch, the longest reigning women's champion in the history of the company. She recently had a vanquisher title because she's having a baby. Kudos to her, she's pregnant. Now, her mantra is, you know, she's the man. So if this song has to do with Becky Lynch's mantra, bro, the correlation is gonna be perfect for me.
They say I played the field before I found someone to commit to.
Okay.
I'd be a fearless leader, I'd be an alpha type. I'm wondering if I'd get there quicker if I was a man.
Oh, shit.
I was a man, then I'd be the man.
Wow, so she's saying she would overcome all these obstacles if she was, you know, a man. But the fact that I'm a woman, I have to work extra hard. And it sucks. It sucks. But society, that's how society's norms are. Society just never wants to adjust. Times are changing. There's a whole woman empowerment movement. There's a lot of women out there that are definitely doing a whole better job than men. But people are still stuck in their ways and they still don't see women doing things that obviously a man could do. So kudos to her for bringing subject matter to this.
Could I be separated from my good ideas and power moves? Let the players play. I'd be just like Leo.
She said, let the players play and not to shake it off. But this is honestly a great song. This is the whole messaging, what the she's referencing. If I was a man, I'll be like the alpha male. I won't just be like the man, I'll be like the man. At this point, this has become vintage Taylor. This has been vintage Taylor for me, at least. She's doing the beat, solid pop, dies out, and then the beat transitions. Like Becky Lynch in the women's division of the WWE, she is the man. She is the woman's champion, and it shows how, like, both women in their respective fields of work, they're respected by not only men and women, but their peers and stuff, because they've overcame a lot of odds and they've accomplished a lot of things. So both women, in retrospect, though they're not just average women, the person like to model and look after based on the obstacles that was presented in front of them. This is such a great song. What? I love the messaging in that song. It definitely is a subject that is sadly still relevant today, and a lot of people hold that certain type of prejudice, which sucks because a lot of people are still stuck in their ways. But that's life. Essentially, how Taylor said, so it goes. That's how life is. Society still holds females to a certain standard, and it sucks because there's a lot of women out there that do a damn better job than a lot of men in their respective industries, and they don't get the credit they deserve. Moving on to the next track, this one is titled The Archer. Ooh, starting serious. She said, I've been the archer, I've been the prey. So is that like her doing the hunting as well as her being the hunted? How she's going after people, but there's still people going after her and they're out to get her, whether it is the media talking what they gotta say, whether it's people online talking what they gotta say. Is that like a double meaning we got going on here? 808's kicking in.
A search for your dark side for years and years.
Wow.
All of my heroes die all alone. Help me hold on.
Holy shit. She said, all of my heroes have died alone. She doesn't want to be the next person that is considered a hero to a lot of people to die alone. Protect me as if I were to protect you. Because she said, I've been the archer, I've been the prey. Wow, this took a twist. Now we're getting vulnerable, Taylor. Wow, she's opening up.
They see right through. Can you see right through me?
Ooh, that just ended. Alright. I like the production on this was great. I liked how it was a simple, like, kind of mysterious, but it still had kind of like that upper echelon vibe that she's still going for. But the 808, it was so calm and it built up perfectly. Lyric-wise, one line that really stood out to me, though, she was like, they see through me. And then she, like, speaking, like, do you see through me? They all see right through me. They see the good. They see the flaws. They see everything. Do you see me for the same thing? Could you honestly relate with these people? Or are you just still, like, in that honeymoon phase and you're not ready to have that conversation? That's deep, too. That is great, man. We're going to transition to the next track. This one is titled, I Think He Knows.
I walk, lead to where I can't stop. Go there every night.
Oof.
I am an architect. I'm drawing up the plans.
Flow's crazy.
It's like I'm 17. Nobody understands. I won't stick around.
Alrighty, she referenced Drake in the beginning with In My Feelings. She just said the good ones never wait. Like Drake said on Take Care, the good ones go if you wait too long. The good ones go if you wait too long.
Obsessed with me and boy, I understand. Boy, I understand.
Oh, this is
Indigo, ooh, I my thigh. We could follow the sparks. I'll drive. The sparks I'll drive.
I like that. I like how Taylor, she starts it off high and then it goes down. You know what I'm saying? I like that. I like how her flow is. I gotta say, the album so far, thus far, it's a totally different vibe from obviously her previous two projects I've reacted to, but it's not bad. She's explaining to everyone what she's going through. As every artist should. Alright. So that song to me, I think he knows, right? Based on the elements she talked about. She's like, he got that boyish look that I like in a man. To me, this is like a first crush type of song. It is her seeing her crush for the first time. And I think he knows. I like him. Hopefully he likes me back. We're going to move on to the next track. This one is titled Miss Americana and the Heartbreak Prince. The production so far, too, is 10 out of 10.
You know I adore you. I'm crazier for you than I was at 16. I saw the scoreboard and ran for my life.
Wow. I'm liking the whole scene she's painting. You know, it's like a high school theme, high school dance, prom maybe, homecoming type of thing.
Team is losing, battered and bruising. I see the high fives. Where are the wise men? Darling, I'm scared.
She's painting a great picture using imagery. She's like, where are the wise men? Is that like about the political state that we're currently in? Because it's based on popularity, essentially comparing that to homecoming. It could be. I could be overthinking it, but we'll see though. Oh man.
And now the storm is coming, but
talk your shit. Oh man, this song is great.
It's so sad we paint the town blue, but it most likely to run under. She's a bad, bad girl.
Still debating. If I had to put a pin on the meaning of the song, I would have to say it has to be about politics. And the only reason why I would say that is because based on the lyrics, I mean, you guys filled me in too. You said that she came out as a Democrat, though the town that she's in Nashville, it's typically Republican. She came out in a Democrat. So what she said, they painted the whole town blue. The Democrat, their color is blue. Republican is red. This is what she believes in. So she came out as a Democrat. Like school politics with actual politics. This is something else. That's genius. Gonna move on to the next track. This one is Paper Rings. This is an upbeat.
Two or three. Now I wake up in the night and watch you breathe.
The one that I want. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Come on now. If that's not a nod to Grease, I don't know what is. This is definitely the pickup I needed. Wow.
You jumped in first, I went into. Ah! With you, even if it makes me blue.
ad-libs. It's kind of like the Blitzkrieg bop. Hey, oh, let's go. This is definitely a solid, oh man, this song just, it's a mood switch up indeed. Right.
It's about to go down.
That's so good. All right, Paper Rings right there, bro. That is a standout for sure right now on this album. It is the perfect pick-me-up. The meaning is great. Listen, the relationship, from what Taylor, from what she's saying, from what I'm going to get at least, the relationship that we're having, it was an accident, but it was an accident that was meant to be. We were friends. As Lil Baby and Gunna would say, we started off as close friends. Somehow you turned into my girlfriend. This accident, it happened, but you know, it is what it is. And the love is so real, it's so mutual. She's saying, I do like my shiny things. Best believe, a girl loves a shiny item. But that materialistic item, that's not a necessity. Because this love, this bond is so beautiful and it's so at its peak that you could even make a paper ring. That's like, the ring is nothing compared to the love. That's getting downloaded. Oh my goodness, what? We're going to move on to the next track. This one is Cornelia Street. I think it's a street in the city, New York City. It sounds very familiar. Dunk on something stronger than the drinks in the bar. Okay, that's a potential Beyonce reference, Drunk in Love. Alright. I never walk Cornelia Street again. It's the kind of heartbreak time could never mend. It's your name. And baby, wow, so that Cornelia Street has some sentimental value to her. Yeah, so that's how you know, like, certain places, and that's very relatable too. Certain places, no matter where you go, who you are, if you see a place, it definitely reminds you of a certain situation. Not the piano, just like that. What? Taylor right now, she's painting a great picture. Especially things in relationships. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys out there could relate. If you're in a current relationship and you have that, like, that go-to, that one spot that you always go to, that one hobby that you guys enjoy doing together, if somewhere down the line the relationship were to go sour, that hobby, that place, It'll never be the same. It'll never have that same lust. It'll never have that it factor. And it's going to bring back too many memories that you don't want to relive because that person either is no longer with you or you don't even want to experience it. So you want to avoid it at all costs. Let's get into this piano, though. What? Oh, bro, don't do this to me. Again. Oh, shit.
It's about to go down.
Just imagine hearing that song live. What? That hits different live. It has to. Oh man. I'm gonna transition to the next track. This one is titled Death by a Thousand Cuts. This beat's building up. It's gonna don't drop, please, I'm not ready. I like her flow. I gotta say, man, if there's one thing consistent with these three Taylor albums, it's her flow. 1000%, man. There's no denying her flow. Production, as always, right now is 10 out of 10. The little pop synths, everything, it's perfect. Taylor is coming blazing right now. My hips, my body, my love. Trying to find a part of me that you didn't touch. Trying to find a part of me that you didn't touch. She's essentially, what's left? The feeling that I once had with you, it's all damaged. So what part of me did you not touch? Oh man, this is too good. This is too good. Damn, she really... Taylor really said, I'm still trying to find the part of me that you didn't touch. I think it touched the soul. You could touch... It's more than a feeling. You know, things of that nature. Man, the lust isn't there for Taylor. She's trying to get over this. There's such powerful meanings on this album. I'm here for this. I am here for this. We're going to move on to the next track. This one is titled London Boy.
Just Ryan London. Oh,
is that Idris? Sounds like Idris.
They say home is where the heart is, but that's not where mine lives.
Wow, yo. She just keeps referencing different artists. The Weeknd, pretty much, he said the same lyrics. He goes, this house is not a home for you. And she's saying this heart is not a home for you. That's a great Weeknd song. If no one's listened to that, that is vintage Abel. The song is titled 28, where the Weeknd says that, but that is vintage Abel. We're not cozy here, people. What?
He likes my American smile like a child, but I see all the rumors are true. No, I'm a London boy.
Whoa. That be, yo. This is, I just love how her production is just like, it's not just one steady beat. It'll be like a beat for like maybe 40, 50 seconds. It'll pause, pick back up, or it'll pause, and then it just transitions to a whole different thing. And that distortion right there, fire.
Mommy in the pub, we are watching rugby.
She loves her bars, huh?
Blue sky, a rainy cab ride. But God, I love the English. You know I love it.
So that's like her scene, right? I guess that's like her go-to. She says she does love a London boy. She like going to the pub. She doesn't enjoy that overseas type of vibe from what I'm getting at. I like it. Oh, I do love me some Soho too. Wow, I haven't been to the city in so long. Alright, so if that song taught me one thing, it's seems like she has a type. The London boys are her type. She likes the rugby. She likes going out with the mates. Yeah, going to the pub. She likes the whole London scene, you know, me in the London. You know, she likes... to me, it seems she likes the aesthetics of London. Because London is reminiscent of some parts of New York City. So I could see the correlation there. She has the type. Move on to the next track. This one is titled, Soon You'll Get Better, featuring the Dixie Chicks. Okay, we got our first feature. Oh, this is acoustic.
I didn't tell you I was scared.
Oh no.
Now I pray to Jesus too.
Oh man, this is gonna be a song that I need a tissue for. I can already feel it. Holding orange bottles. Is that like prescriptions? Cause they come in a little orange cylinder. Oh man, don't make me cry, Taylor. I am in no shape to cry right now. Please don't.
Ooh, soon you'll get better.
It's gonna happen. I'm gonna cry. I know it. Oh, not the violins. Oh, man. Oh, boy. Come on. I was. Who? Why? Why?
What am I supposed to do?
Oh, man.
There's no you.
Man, she's really just said if there's no you, and then we had a moment of silence as if they're gone. Come on, Taylor, man. Why do you have to paint such perfect pictures? All right, let's continue.
You get better soon.
Not the gasp, man. Oh, man, my heart right there. The gasp as, oh, man, that she's at an awe too. Tough times. This is tough times, man. Oh, bro, man. So poetic. So beautiful. So perfectly said. I don't know if this is weird, but I'm digging the slower, more vulnerable, intimate, emotional songs on this album than the more upbeat. Though the upbeat songs are cool and I like them, I'm just feeling the more connection with the slower ones. I don't know if you guys can attest to that. I mean, it's just me, I guess, but Because a lot of the slower, not like upbeat to the point where it's like adrenaline rush type of vibe, like a Paper Rings, for example. Slower songs that they paint the picture, you put yourself in perspectives. I feel a solid connection with. We'll move on to the next track. This one is False God. Okay, saxophone.
We were crazy to think.
Smooth jazz, I like it.
Then if it's a false god, we still worship this a lot. A golden when you touch me, honey, hell is when I fight with you.
Ooh. Yeah, it's becoming clear. Okay. Yeah, so she answered my own question. She's definitely relating it to religion. And she said she got the wine ready. You know, when you're meeting with the priest at the end of Mass, you get the wine and you get the holy bread. So she's treating the relationship like wine. And during our confession, we confess over a bottle of wine. It's a false god because the religion... All right, it's all coming full circle. I'm connecting the dots.
Still worship this love.
Take us to church, Taylor. Come on. She's masking regular, like, figurative objects, regular themes, with correlating to actual, like, stuff in real life. She's using the actual, what she wants to portray, hidden with these objects. This is something else. We move into the final five. The next one is titled, You Need to Calm Down.
But you're taking shots at me like it's Patron, and I'm just like, damn.
That's right.
It's 7 a.m.
Like, I'll just reference Drake, because she already started it. I'll finish it off. Like Drake said on Scorpion, opinions from total strangers take me out of my ways. Inefficient searching for praise. Listen, you're hiding behind this device here. You really think that you're all big and mighty, but like she said, you see me in person, it's a knockout.
Somebody that we don't know, but you're coming at my friends like a missile. Control your urges to scream about all the people you hate.
Facts.
Calm down. And we see you over there on the internet, comparing all the girls.
Talking about, you know, all the negativity that's out there. People talk and bash and say literally everything and anything on the internet. Deep down, if you were to see me in person, she's not saying this, but we all know, if you see them deep down, your mood is going to switch completely, and you're going to be the nicest person, and eventually you're going to want to take a picture. You're going to want to take a picture, and all this negativity that you're talking on the internet, it's not real, so you need to calm down. So the beat, synth, incredible. You can forgive and forget when it comes to the words, but once it's on the internet, it's there forever. It is there forever, and there's no turning back. So you take the good with the bad, but Taylor takes it without. The next track, this one is Afterglow. I'm liking the vibe. It's super slow. It's like empowering, and you could tell, like, this right now, this is Taylor just like pouring out her heart to whoever, most likely Joe, but like whoever, just pouring it out. Taylor is realizing that it's all me, you know, it's my bad, it's my fault. We're gonna work this out, and when we work it out, here's my solution. You meet me at the afterglow, with the afterglow. So she's admitting to whatever fault it was that she put upon this relationship, and she's being the bigger person and she's taking the blame for it. That's what I'm getting at it, at least, though. Okay, once again, I'm digging vulnerable Taylor. It's not you, it's me. Let's work it out. And looks as if she did work it out, and the solution that she brought upon worked, and she was the bigger person. So salute to her for admitting to her faults like that. We're gonna move on to the next one. This one is titled Me, with another feature. Brandon Urie. Okay.
Promise that you'll never find another like me. I know that I'm a handful.
Wait a minute. This sounds vaguely familiar. I'm gonna let the song play out, because I think I'm gonna wait to make my point, but it sounds vaguely familiar.
find another like me.
Oh, yep. This is it. Okay, I actually heard this song on Sunday night. Sunday night, I was, you know, casual, just chilling in my living room, watching The Last Dance, which is the Jordan documentary that ESPN put out, finally. So far, it's 10 out of 10. I got no complaints. Excellent. Commercial hits. It is a credit card. To be honest, it was either a Capital One, it was either MasterCard or Visa. I can't remember which brand, but it was definitely one of those three for sure. Taylor Swift, she was like working behind the counter at the diner. She was like serving food, making ice cream sundaes, and it was essentially advertising whatever card it was that you could get like cash back for it. And this song was playing, which was odd because I put out the reaction videos, and then I'm watching the TV just casually, and I see a commercial with Taylor Swift, and it was this song. Incredible.
But I will never fall you, baby. Promise that you'll never find another like me.
That's so clean. The switch up. This is better than what I heard in the commercial. What? That's crazy. It's crazy how like little things like this just works. I've never reacted to Taylor Swift ever. Put a couple videos out on the channel. Next thing you know, I'm just casually watching a basketball documentary, and a commercial with Taylor Swift pops up and this song plays. Meanwhile, this song was on the album that a lot of people wanted me to react to. The correlation, it's just crazy to even think about all the little nuances and dots that are connected right here, but this switch up right here is getting real. Game changer. It's an upbeat song, obviously, but to me, it's more than just an upbeat song. It's an anthem, essentially. It's more than just an upbeat hit single. It's got the deep meaning, but it's also super upbeat. It's super upbeat, and it puts you in that mood, so that's a solid third to last track on this album. We're gonna move on to the next one. This one's titled, It's Nice to Have a Friend. Sounds like a Young Thug beat, if I'm being completely honest here. Okay. Before I interrupt Taylor, I gotta say right now, if there was a trap beat over this instrumental, if there is a trap beat on this song, which I don't think so, but if a person were to remix this and put a trap beat over it, bro, you know how fire that beat sound? Put Young Thug, Future, and Lil Baby on this song, killer, right there.
Note, sleeping in tents, it's nice to have a friend. Any questions would tell the truth lately, yeah, me too, something.
That's a scene right there, on the roof, looking at the pink sky, 20 questions asking each other, what's the matter? It's nice to have more than a friend, but to Taylor, it's the relationship, but it's more than a relationship, it's your best friend.
Like snow, call my bluff, call you babe. It's nice to have a friend.
Get you somebody who could do both. Let's literally get you somebody who could do both. Damn. Literally, we started off as close friends. Somehow you turned into my girlfriend. Literally is what the theme of this song is. I'm digging the slower, more vulnerable tracks where she's pouring out her heart, letting you know what is on her chest. The upbeat songs are cool, and they get the message across, and it's a mood switch, which is why I like it. I'm feeling more of the vulnerable tracks and the slower beats for sure. You go from 1989, Clean, incredible closeout. New Year's Day, Reputation, incredible closeout. This next one right here. This next one, I'm going to hold to a certain standard, unless she switches up the vibe. I don't know, but I'm holding it to a certain standard. The last and final track on this stellar album is titled Daylight.
I'll tell you the truth, but never goodbye. Been sleeping so long in a 20-year dark night. I'm in this town.
As the beat is building up, Taylor's flow is switching up, so this is... It's vintage Taylor. I like it. One thing I've noticed about this album, the way she uses colors, it's just impeccable. You know, she talked about the pink sky, blue eyes, golden. Now we're talking about 20 years in a dark night. Now she's seeing the daylight. So 20 years in the darkness of constantly getting treated like garbage. I potentially may have found the person that is bringing sun to my life that has been so shady all these years.
Gotta step into the daylight and let it go.
I wanna be defined by the things that I love. You are what you love.
Nicely said. I gotta say, that final track, it lived up to my expectations of what I would hold it in the echelon of a clean, a New Year's Day, and not daylight. It's solid closeout, and it painted a perfect picture. And that voice memo that she just left right there, it's easier said than done. You are what you love. As an overall project that she put together, it's nicely well put. It is a perfectly put together project. How this album differs from the others, I feel like what she did with this one to get the overall message in the story, you literally have to listen to track 1 to 18. As opposed to Reputation in 1989, you could play that album on shuffle. You really could play that album on shuffle and you won't get lost in translation and the messages. The color scheme I definitely liked a lot. I like the upbeat songs, don't get me wrong, but I more so lean towards the more slower, vulnerable Taylor, admitting to her faults and embracing the relationship type of Taylor. Like I said, if you would contest to that, definitely let me know down below or reach out to me however you feel would get your message and point across. Definitely looking forward to seeing this live, ABC Sunday night. Hopefully she dibbles and dabbles into other albums, but if it's just strictly Lover, I'm cool with it. I'll definitely drop your recommendations as you've been doing down below. It's greatly appreciated. Like, comment, and subscribe. If you're new to the channel and you're seeing me for the first time and you're not subscribed, join the movement. Click the subscribe button on the channel. You get two buttons for the price of $3.99. Click the subscribe button. You subscribe to the channel. Click the post notification bell. You get notified on the hour when I exactly post the video. So why not join the movement? Most definitely send me a follow on social media. Instagram and Twitter is both _Fabrizio13. So once you follow me, feel free, gladly reach out. I definitely will answer it. Because without you guys, this whole channel is impossible. So that's my way of giving back. Thank you for supporting the channel and everything. Till the very next video, I am out of here. See you guys later.